back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss heap sort. So it's a very important sorting algorithm, and most of us we generally leave it because we like, you know, like merge sort, quick sort, it's more, they are more asked in interviews, but heap sort is also asked in interviews and it's really important to know. So let's start. What is heap sort? So heap sort is a sorting algorithm, right? And what we do in heap sort is basically, it's quite similar to selection sort. Quite similar, like the overall approach is similar to selection sort. So in selection sort, what we do is we first of all find the minimum element. We find the minimum element and then like we swap it with the one which is present at the zeroth index of the array. So in the whole array, we'll find the minimum and we will place it at the zeroth index. So because we are sorting in ascending order, increasing order, so this is how selection sort works. So heap sort also kind of works similar only. So let's see how heap sort works. And it's a humble request that if you haven't seen the previous video in which we implemented heap, so I'll give the link in the description. You can check that video first because that concept is we will use here in this video. So I hope you have seen that video. Okay, so what we do in heap sort is, first of all, we make a max heap. We make a max heap, and then what happens in a max heap? In max heap, the root is the maximum value, Root is the maximum value. So if we have made the max heap, then we know that at zeroth index of the array, like suppose this array is representing my heap. So we know how to represent array, how to represent heap in the form of array. So if you don't know, please check the previous video. Link will be in the description. So if we have made the max heap, then the largest element will be here at the zeroth index, right? So then what we can do is, we know that the largest element is at the zeroth index. So what we will do, we will just move this largest element to the end of the array. We will swap it with the end element because we want to sort it in increasing order, increasing order. So if we know this is the highest largest element, so we will put it at the end. So then after that, what we'll do, we will again we will heapify, basically we will do something such that again the maximum element, which is the second largest element, comes at the zeroth index. So then we will put it again at the end. So this is some, if you didn't get it, don't worry, we'll see it in the video. So let's see how we are going to do how heap sort works. So in heap sort, what we do, let me do the indexing first. So if this is the array given, right, we need to sort it in increasing order. So if we sort it in increasing order, it will be something like this: 5, 6, 7, 11, 12 and 13. So first of all, what we will do in this is, we are given this array, right? 12, 11, 13, this one. So what our main aim is, first of all, what is our objective, that we need to make it as a max heap. We need to make it as a max heap. That means at the zeroth index of this array, largest number should come. At the zeroth index, largest element of the array should come, because we are making a max heap. So how we will do that? We will start from, see, if n is over here, n is 6, right? There are 6 elements in the array, so n is 6. We will start iterating from n by 2 minus 1 index till zeroth index. Why so? You'll get to understand. So n by 2 minus 1, this will be 6 by 2 minus 1, this will be 2. So we will start from 2 index and we'll go, I will decrement and it will go till zeroth index. So first of all, initially our pointer i is here. So this is our parent index, right? We are taking this i as parent index, and if you have followed the previous video, you will know that if we need to know the left child index using parent index, so it will be 2 into, if the parent index is I, then it will be 2 into I plus 1 for left child, and for right child it will be 2 into I plus 2, where I is the parent index. So here what we are taking is parent index as 2. So parent index is 2, so left child index will be 2 into 2 plus 1 will be 5, and right child index will be 2 into 2 plus 2, so it will be 6. But since 6 is out of bound, we only have till index till 5, so this will not be considered, right? So what we will check now in max heap, what we do, we will check if this parent, if like we will check if the child is greater than parent. What ultimately we need to do is we need to have the largest element over here na, at the zeroth index. So we will check if the child value, the in value at index 5, which is 7, is it greater than the parent value 13? No. So nothing needs to be done. This 13 is greater than the child, so parent value is greater than child, it's okay. In max heap, what we have in max heap, the parent value should be greater than children, na? That's why it's max heap. So and in this over here, 13 is greater than 7, which is correct. So now we will decrement our I was ranging from 2 to 0, na? So now I will come here, I will go to 1. So now again we will calculate the left child and right child. So now left child will be, since this is our parent, so 2 into 1 plus 1, so this will come out to be 3, and right child will come out to be 2 into 1 plus 2, so this will be 4. So this left child is at index 3, right child is at index 4. So 11 parent, is it greater, we will check if the child is greater than the parent. Child value at child left child is 5. No, it's not greater, so it's correct as of now. Parent is greater, which is correct. Then we will check if the value which is at right child, like if the right child value, which is 6, is it greater than the parent? No. So parent is correct. It's something like 11, 5 and 6. So parent is greater. So this is properties also correct. So we will not do anything. It's correct. So what we will do is we will decrement I again. So I will now go to 0. I will go to 0. So I will come here. See, I comes here. Again we will find out left child. So left child will be 2 into 0 plus 1 will be 1, and right child will be 2 into 0 plus 2 will be 2. Now it's very important step. Now see, the left child value is 11, is it greater than the parent 12? No. The right child value at index 2 is 13, is it greater than the parent is 12? Yes, it's greater than parent. So what we will do is we will swap these two. We will make the right child as parent. So 13 comes here and 12 comes here and 13 goes there, right? And now what we will do is, since now we 12 comes here na, so what we will do, we will start now, this will our parent will become this, like our parent index will become this, and we will check from this again that is there any change made. So 12 is greater than so child, so nothing will be changed. So this is one step. Now if you will notice that once this loop is completed, you will check that the largest element has now moved to the zeroth index. See, don't worry about this 11, 12, they are not in sync, 12 is greater than, why it's like after 11, don't don't think about that, but just check that 13, which was the greatest element, is now at the 0th index after doing this loop. We iterated from n by 2 minus 1 to 0, and every time we were checking that if child arr of left child, is it greater than parent, or if it is greater than swap, or the right child value, is it greater than the parent. If this is, then we will swap them. So this is what we did, right? This is what we did. And after doing this, the maximum element is at the starting. Now the next step is very important. So let's see the code up till this. Up till this, we can say that we have made a max heap. This is a max heap because the maximum element is at the root. This is a root, na, 0th index. So we have made the max heap. So max heap is done. Let's see the code for this so that you get to understand. So see, in the code, what is given, we have taken the same array, and n is given, the size of array. We have made a function heap sort, passing array and the number of elements in array. And after that, we are just simply printing the sorted array. Let's see the heap sort function. So in the heap sort, this print function is simple, right? The heap sort function, first of all, we are building the heap, right? We are building the max heap, and we have iterated from n by 2 minus 1 till 0th index, and we are calling this heapify function. Now, what does this heapify does? In nutshell, what heapify does is, it will always bring the maximum element in the array at the 0th index. I'll repeat that heapify, what does this function do? Heapify function will always bring the maximum element in the array to the 0th index. If you see, right now what we did was, we just did heapify means that the maximum element in the array will come to the 0th index, right? So every time from we are iterating from n by 2 minus 1 till 0, and we are calling heapify function, that means we are passing I every time, because if you remember, I was here initially, then I was here, then I was here, right? So let's see the heapify function. If you understood heapify, the algorithm is very easy, right? See heapify function. In the heapify function, array is in the parameters, there are array, size of array, and the current index. So let's take that currently this I is parent, right? It's parent index. So let's take this is the largest index, like the value parent. We are supposing that the parent value is largest as of now. So we have stored in the largest this I index. We are calculating the left child index, right child index, using these formulas we know. And then we are checking that if, first of all, if this L is in the bounds, like it's not getting out of bound, and if the element which is at the left child, that means if the left child is greater than the parent, this is a problem, right? Because in max heap, always the parent is greater, but here the left child is greater, then just store in the largest value as left child index, because it is greater. And then if we'll again check if the right child, it could be also a case, na, that if right child is greater than the maybe the parent or left child, right? So what this condition will check, if right is in bounds and if arr of r is greater than the largest element, right? So if that is the case, then right child is greater, so largest will store right child index value. After this loop, in the largest, our largest value will, largest values index will be there, right? And if it is not equal to the parent index, right? Parent index means one of the child. Like if you see over here, what we did was we swapped 12. Earlier here 13 was there, na, and 12 was here, and this was a parent, and this was the right child. This was the right child. This was the parent. So over here, right child was greater than parent. So we swapped both, right? So 12 came here and 13 got there, right? And after that, swap. So swap, and then again you need to call the heapify function. Why? Now this could be a question that why are we again calling the heapify function? This is because maybe since you have swapped these two, na? Since you have swapped these two, might be a case that there is a value which is greater than this value which comes here, right? So 12 came here, na? 12 came here. Might, like, let's suppose there is over here, there is a value which is greater than 12. So again we need to check for that. We again need to left child, right child, compare and that. So that's why we are again calling recursively if we did swap. So if this condition, if like control goes in this if condition, then only this heapify will be done again. Otherwise, if the parent is child, parent value is greater, then it will never go in this if, because the largest value will be equal to I, right? I hope you are getting it. Just dry run if you didn't get, or do you have, if you have any doubt, just dry run this heapify method, you will understand. And once you are clear with heapify, suppose like you can assume that heap sort is done, right? So I'm assuming that you got that how this heapify is working. So after making the max heap, what, like after this loop, this for loop, after this for loop, we can assume that the maximum element will come at the 0th index. So 13, 11, 12, 5, 6 and 7. So this will be the array formed. Now, after that, what we'll do is, we know that at 0th index, we have the maximum value, right? So we will swap, because we are sorting in ascending order, na? So the largest value will be at the end. So what we'll do, we will swap 13 and 7. So 13 comes here, 7 goes there, right? So what we are doing, we are iterating from the last index, and what we are doing, we are swapping the last element with the 0th index, because we know at 0th index largest value is there. So we are swapping the last element with this 13. So now 13 is there at the end and 7 is in the start. Now again we need to find the maximum element in this array. So what we'll do is we need that the maximum element comes at the 0th index again, so that we can again shift it to the end, right? This is, so now what does the, what function does this thing, that like the, which function brings the maximum element to the 0th index? It's the heapify function, na? So once we swapped the largest with the the largest 0th index element with the last index, then we will decrease the array size, because this is at its, this 13 is at its position. So then this will be the array which will go in the heapify. So if you see, we are starting from I n minus 1 till 0, swapped the last element, and now we are calling heapify function. Heapify, it's starting, like parent index is starting from 0, that means this will be our I, this will be left child, then right child, like that. And see, n, there the second parameter was n, na? Now n is I, means I, like earlier we started I from here, means 5, but now since this is done, na? So this is done, so now 4, so this is 4, 3, 2 and 1. Right, so our array, we are taking this much as array. So that's why we are passing I. That means this I, which was this 5, we are currently, I is here, na? I is here. So now this 5 is the length of array. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So like this, every time what we will do is, what you will do is, suppose now this here 12 comes, right? Suppose after heapify 12 comes here, because it's the largest element, then you will swap 12 with 6. So 6 comes here, 12 goes there. Then you will again decrease the size of array, again call heapify, like this. So this is the process how the heap sort works. So after this loop, your array will be sorted in the increasing order, and you can print the array then. So this is a heap sort. I hope you understood it. It's very simple. Initially, we think that what is this heapify doing, and why we are using this loop. But if you dry run, you will easily understand. Heapify function just does this much, that it brings the largest element to the zeroth index, right? So I hope you understood the heap sort algorithm. If you find it the video useful, please like it, subscribe to my channel please, and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any video, and yeah, share with your friends also. Okay, bye, see you in the next video.